Hi, today we're going to continue our look at our studio, and this time around we are going to take a look at a tethering stand, portable one, that we made together with Kupo and a few of their products. So let's take a look. Today we continue our studio tour and we want to concentrate on one particularly cool rig that we created that we feel has a lot of potential and has already proved to be quite handy. We are talking about a compact yet powerful computer with a large high-resolution monitor connected to a mobile rolling platform that we connect to our camera when we shoot videos, both for monitoring and for actually controlling the camera in real time. So let's break down the components that make our rig. We'll start with the stand. For this project, we received a 322M wheeled monitor stand from Kupo along with a number of other accessories. The 322M is a super robust stand with two risers that can go up to 1.9 meters or 75 inches or down to 95 centimeters or 37 inches. It has three wheeled legs that you can fold for storage with one leg that can extend from 75 centimeters to a full meter, almost 40 inches, if you want more stability on one side. Like most stands, it has a male stud on top, so in order to connect the monitor, we got from Kupo the KS-429 VESA mount kit. Think about it as a very robust ball head that can hold your monitor if it has a 75 by 75 or 100 by 100 VESA connection and allows you to change its position. It can hold up to 8 kilograms or 17.5 pounds, and if you want to use a heavier monitor like a TV for example, Kupo has a different model. But for our purposes, this unit works fantastically well, just like the stand itself, which glides on the floor. The second major component is the computer that we are going to use. We wanted something small yet powerful enough that we can possibly do some other stuff with in the future. But if you're only looking to control your camera and view the camera feed live, you can get by with far less powerful setup. We chose the Intel Nook 1850 BEH computer with a Samsung SSD 970 NVMe drive and 60 GB of RAM. This is a very powerful yet very small and compact setup, which is basically silent. Although you can basically pick any type of monitor for this task, as photographers we wanted a quality monitor with good colors, 4K resolution, VESA mount, and of course a reasonable price. We decided to go for the BenQ PD2700U, 27-inch 4K HDR IPS monitor. For some reason, our other studio monitor didn't seem to play nice with the Nook HDMI out, but the BenQ works fantastically well. In order to mount the computer onto the screen while it is itself mounted onto a VESA mount to the stand, we needed a dual VESA bracket. This was a little bit of a challenge to install, but we eventually were able to connect the Silverstone Technology Nook monitor arm extension bracket with a VESA mount to both the Nook and the monitor and stand. Alongside the stand, Kupo sent us a number of connectors and adapters. We will discuss some of them in a later video, but the two that we have been using for this project are the KS031 snap-in right angle baby pin connected to a stand via a super clamp. This is a very sturdy combo and we use it to hold some of the long cables that we use for tethering, as well as a case with a mouse and a keyboard for the computer. This might not exactly be essential, but it is certainly convenient, and if you need an extra place to hang a light, you can use their arm for that as well. We have mentioned cables just now, and we have been using one of Tether Tools' Tether Pro 15-foot USB cables. They are not just super flexible, but they are also long and very durable. No less important than all of the hardware is the software that we are going to use for this project. We tried more than half a dozen different software, and although for stills tethering there are many options, for video there are surprisingly limited number of good ones. In the past we used and loved DSLR dashboard software, but this software hasn't been updated in a while and it doesn't work with our Sony A6500 wired at all and has many issues connecting wirelessly. after testing quite a few other options, we decided to give Sony's own free software, imaging and remote, a chance, and at the moment this is what we're using, and we will dive into it and some of its limitations in a moment. If you have a positive experience with Sony cameras and some other software for shooting tethered video, please let us know in the comments. One last piece of gear before we actually talk about how we use this whole setup has been our trusty Stream Deck Mini Keyboard. We have reviewed this fantastic piece of gear several months ago and love it so much that we bought another one for the studio. The reason that we mentioned the Stream Deck here has to do with Sony's Imaging Edge Remote software's ability to operate the camera using shortcuts. Since you can assign these shortcuts through the Stream Deck, this means that you can shoot and change key settings in your camera with a single press of the button on your Stream Deck. And this works actually pretty well and is very useful. As we have mentioned on our studio tour video, we record two main types of videos on our studio. LensVid videos, which are typically product reviews, although we also do interviews and some DIY and project videos such as the one that you are watching right now. We also work on our vegan food channel Veggies, where we record videos of vegan food recipes. Both for product shots and for our recipes, we record a lot of footage from an overhead camera. We'll be making a separate video about that project, which is currently ongoing. This means that the camera that we use is out of our reach unless we use a ladder or an Apple box and we need a way to both see and control the camera remotely. Another situation where we need to control the camera remotely and see what we are shooting on a different screen than the one on the back of the camera is when we record the intro and conclusion bits of our videos on LensVid. For both these tasks, we created the rolling studio shooting ring. It is easy to move around the studio and we can place it either near the main table or close to the LensVid shooting station. Working with the Sony Imaging Edge Remote software is pretty simple. You need to make sure that the Sony camera USB connection setting is set to PC remote and connect the camera to the computer using a USB cable. Sadly, wireless connection to the PC or Mac is not possible at this stage. This is not the only drawback. Many of the main features of this software do not seem to work with older Sony cameras, even our A6500 quite unfortunately. For example, all focus functions do not work, so you can't really control the focus at all from the computer. We communicated this and a number of other limitations to Sony recently, and we can only hope that they are listening and working on resolving this in a future update of the software. Despite these limitations, even with the current Imaging Edge Remote software, you can change many of the camera settings quite easily. That is, if the screen is close to you, since on our 27-inch 4K, the icons and text is super small, another thing we hope Sony will fix in a future update. Finally, we wanted to demonstrate how cool it is to use our Elgato Stream Deck for camera control. We assigned specific buttons for stills and video, changing ISO and other settings and everything with simple and clear button presses. Really, the only drawback aside from the cost of the Stream Deck is that it isn't wireless, and we have found no easy way to turn it wireless. And trust us, we have looked. This means that you either need to be close or use an extension cord, which isn't really ideal. So despite all these drawbacks and limitations of our rig and software, we discovered that being able to view what we are shooting on a large high-resolution color-calibrated monitor while being able to control the camera quickly and directly is very handy. Although there are surely simpler and far less expensive solutions such as working with apps on tablets or even smartphones, at the moment and for our workflow, this feels like the best option that we could come up with, and if it fits your workflow and you have the budget, we can highly recommend it. So that was our look at the Kupo portable stand with our tethered computer station, which we're using actually right now. You can read the full article on lensvid.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to find more videos just like this. See you next time.